Hello everyone, I am Dr. Trupti and this is my YouTube channel Enjoy Biochemistry. In video lecture series on molecular biology, today's video is about structure, functions and post-transcriptional modifications of ribosomal RNA and transfer RNA. We know that in eukaryotes there are three types of RNA polymerase: RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2 and 3. And RNA polymerase 2 is responsible for synthesis of messenger RNA, while RNA polymerase 1, it is responsible for synthesis of ribosomal RNA, specifically 5.8, 18 and 20S ribosomal RNA, and 5S ribosomal RNA synthesis occurs with the help of RNA polymerase 3. So let's first see what are these ribosomal RNA. Ribosomal RNA, these are the type of non-coding RNAs and these are primary components of ribosomes. What are ribosomes? They are machinery for translation, that is protein synthesis, which occurs in the cytoplasm. And these ribosomes are cytoplasmic nucleoproteins because they are made up of RNA as well as proteins. So 65% of these ribosomes are RNAs, that is ribosomal RNAs, and 35% is protein. And this ribosomal RNA is 80% of total RNA present in the cell. Eukaryotic ribosome, it is made up of two subunits. The smaller one is 40S and the bigger one is 60S, and together it is called as 80S ribosome. This S represents sedimentation coefficient, which is also called as Swedberg value. And this Swedberg value, it is determined by both shape as well as size. And that's why the numeric values are not strictly additive. That's why 40S and 60S together becomes 80S ribosome. And the smaller subunit, it is made up of 18S ribosomal RNA and about 30 proteins. And the bigger subunit, that is 60S subunit, it is made up of 5S ribosomal RNA, 5.8S ribosomal RNA and 28S ribosomal RNA. And it also has around 50 proteins. These ribosomes are the factories of protein synthesis and they can be present in the cytosol as free or can be also present in the association with RUP and endoplasmic reticulum. Transcription by RNA polymerase 1 produces a single precursor that encodes three RNA components of the ribosome, that is 18S, 5.S and 28S. So it is the pre-RNA transcript, which is 45S. And it undergoes nucleotide modification, methylation and pseudouridine conversion. And after cleavage, there is formation of separate ribosomal RNA, that is 18S, 5.8S and 28S ribosomal RNA in the nucleolus. And then they are transported to cytoplasm, where the 18S ribosomal RNA becomes the part of smaller subunit of ribosome, that is 40S. And both 5.8S and 20S, they become part of 60S ribosome. And along with this 5.8S and 28S, there is one more ribosomal RNA, that is 5S, but this is not synthesized by RNA polymerase 1. It is synthesized separately by RNA polymerase 3, but later it becomes the part of this bigger subunit of eukaryotic ribosome, that is the 60S ribosome, ribosomal subunit. tRNA synthesis occurs with the help of RNA polymerase 3 in the nucleoplasm, and this transfer RNA, they are called as transfer RNA because they transfer specific activated amino acid from cytoplasm to ribosome for protein biosynthesis. And these transfer RNA, they are single strand polynucleotide which are present in the cytoplasm. And they are easily soluble, that's why they are also called as soluble RNA or sRNA. But they are very stable. The primary tRNA transcript, it is very large because it contains extra nucleotide at 5' end and 3' end, as well as their introns are present in the anticodon loop and even the bases are not modified. So which are those various post-transcriptional modifications? First one is removal of 16 nucleotide sequence at 5' end by RNase P. Then removal of uracil residues and addition of CCA sequence at 3' end by nucleotidyl transferase. Then modification of bases, that is U is reduced to dihydrouracil. Then formation of pseudouridine, methylation of bases, deamination. So all these base modifications occur, and there is removal of 14 nucleotide introns from the anticodon site of nucleases. So all these modifications occur in the primary tRNA transcript to form mature transfer RNA. Mature transfer RNA constitutes 20% of total cellular RNA, and its secondary structure is clover leaf shape. Tertiary structure is L-shaped, and it is 74 to 95 nucleotides long. Cytoplasmic translational system possesses 31 transfer RNA, while mitochondrial translational system possesses 22 transfer RNA. And this transfer RNA has various arms. The first is acceptor arm. This is DHU arm, TCIC arm, anticodon arm, and the fifth one is extra or variable arm. So first is the acceptor arm of transfer RNA, and this acceptor arm is present at 3' end of tRNA. And this 3' end is the amino acid attachment site or amino acid acceptor site, and it has 7 base pairs. And these 7 base pairs, it terminates with the triplet CCA sequence. That is cytosine, cytosine, and adenine. And this CCA sequence attaches the activated amino acid. So it is the site of attachment of amino acid. And how this amino acid is attached to this adenine? The carboxyl group of this amino acid is attached to 3' hydroxyl group of adenosyl moiety. So this is the acceptor arm. And each tRNA carries only one amino acid and transport activated amino acid to ribosome for protein synthesis. The second arm of transfer RNA is anticodon arm. This is opposite to the acceptor arm, and it is 5 base pair long. And this anticodon arm, it has triplet nucleotide sequence which are complementary to the codon of amino acid which the transfer RNA carries. For example, this is the transfer RNA specific for methionine. So it has anticodon UAC, that is, and this anticodon is read from 3' to 5' direction, that is 3' UAC 5'. And it forms base pair with the codon present on the messenger RNA, that is AUG. The codon is read from 5' to 3', that is 5' AUG 3'. So the anticodon codon pairing is complementary and it is antiparallel. So this transfer RNA shows dual specificity, one in recognizing the messenger RNA codon and second in accepting that specific amino acid coded by that particular codon. So this is the anticodon arm of transfer RNA. This is the DHU or dihydrouracil arm. And this contains modified base, that is dihydrouracil residue. And this DHU arm, or it is also called as D arm, it acts as a recognition site for specific amino acid tRNA synthetase. And opposite to this D arm, TCIC arm is present. It is also called as pseudouridine arm. TCIC stands for ribothymidine, pseudouridine, and cytidine. And this arm is involved in the binding of amino acyl tRNA to the ribosomal surface. The fifth arm of transfer RNA is extra arm or variable arm. And this is present between pseudouridine and anticodon arm. It is the most variable feature of transfer RNA, and it varies in size from 3 to 21 base pairs. There are different classes of transfer RNA which is based on this extra arm, and class 1 transfer RNA has variable loop having 3 to 5 base pair, and it constitutes about 75% of total transfer RNAs, and class 2 transfer RNA has 13 to 21 base pairs, and probably it has role in process of codon recognition by certain transfer RNAs. Transfer RNA are able to carry a specific amino acid, and they are able to recognize the codon for that particular amino acid, and therefore they function as an adapter molecule. So they serve as adapter for the translation of information which is there in the sequence of nucleotides of that messenger RNA into specific amino acids. At least one specific type of transfer RNA is required per amino acids, and there are about 50 species of transfer RNA and 20 different amino acids are there. So some amino acids have more than one specific transfer RNA molecule, and this is particularly true for those amino acids which are coded by several codons. In today's video, we have studied the role of ribosomal RNA in the process of protein synthesis. Ribosomal RNA are component of ribosomes, which is the factory of protein synthesis. And transfer RNA carries amino acid from the cytoplasm to ribosomal protein synthesizing machinery. So all the RNAs, messenger RNA, ribosomal RNA and transfer RNA, all are required in the process of translation. So the transfer RNA carries specific amino acid to the ribosome so that the information present in the messenger RNA in the form of nucleotide sequence can be translated in the form of amino acids.